Good evening. It was an act of pure evil carried out by a monster. Hannah Clarke and her three children murdered by the man who should have loved them most. 2 years on from the shocking act of domestic violence, a coroner is now examining whether more could have been done to save them. Hannah's parents were in court today as heroic neighbours recounted their desperate attempts to help the family.
2 years since their family was torn apart, Sue and Lloyd Clarke sat stoically in the coroner's court, reliving the horror of the day their precious daughter and grandchildren were murdered.
Just supporting each other. We have seen some of the things and we've heard some of what's going on, so, yeah, we'll just be there for each other. It will be hard and I will cry, I always cry, but we'll get there.
It was a calculated plan by a highly manipulative man to try and reassert control over his family. During the morning school run, Rowan Baxter ambushed Hannah Clarke and her three children, 6-year-old Aaliyah, 4-year-old Layana, and 3-year-old Trey. He forced his way into the passenger seat and ordered Hannah to drive before dousing their car with petrol and setting it alight. In the moments before the car exploded, Hannah pulled into Michael Zemek's driveway as he was washing his car. Baxter had Hannah in a bear hug, both arms around her. Hannah was screaming out, "Call the police, call the police. He's trying to kill me. He's poured petrol on me." As I approached the window, it just went bang. Neighbours who heard Hannah's chilling screams used garden hoses in a desperate attempt to try to extinguish the inferno. Engulfed in flames, Hannah's only concern was for her children. "I've got a DVO. I can't believe he's done this. Where are my babies? Where are my kids? How could he do this?"
They were young, vibrant.
Beautiful people.
She loved her children.
Yeah.
Those who ran to Hannah's aid that day described Rowan Baxter's demeanour as angry and agitated. They said he was pacing around the car as though he was guarding it, getting in the way of anyone trying to put out the fire. He then grabbed a knife and fatally stabbed himself in the chest. Hannah's family hope the inquest will drive change to combat the scourge of domestic violence.
Yeah, just hoping that we can get some more procedures in place,
yeah.
Perpetrator intervention.
Nothing will erase their pain. All they want now is to prevent another family from enduring the same heartache.
Samantha Butler is at the coroner's court. She joins us now in Brisbane. Sam, no doubt this will be an extremely difficult process for the Clarke family.
Well, Sandra, today was the first of what's likely to be many harrowing days of evidence. Over the next week and a half, more than 30 witnesses are expected to testify, including first responders, domestic violence experts, friends and family of Hannah Clarke and Rowan Baxter. The inquest will look back at the years leading up to the tragedy and the escalating risk Baxter posed to determine whether any warning signs were missed and what could be done differently in the future. Perhaps the most poignant evidence, though, will come a little later this week, when Hannah's mother, Sue Clarke, takes the stand to testify. She told us today she is nervous but determined to do so, to give her daughter a voice, one which was so cruelly taken away. Sandra?
All right, Sam, thank you.